I just want to say thank you guys for having me. I want to give you guys a little bit of a background of how my time was in care and how this pandemic is affecting me right now. So I entered care when I was 14 to the age of 21. I turned 21 last year in 2019. When I aged out of care, I did age out with some type of housing. I was living in NYCHA. I had a one bedroom, but a couple months after I had aged out, I was going through so much. I had a domestic violence case open. I had three babies and I didn't have any money to move. I didn't have any support and I didn't know what I was gonna do. Now, place yourself in the middle of a pandemic. You just turned 21. On my birthday, we signed the papers. They didn't wait. They didn't make sure that I was ready to be on my own. They didn't make sure that I had food, that my bills were paid, that I even understood how to pay my portion of my rent. Being on public assistance for the first time, one of the most struggling things was learning how to pay my own portion of rent, what I had to pay, childcare, how my babies were going to be in school, how I was going to be able to work to put the next plate of food on the table. It was very struggling at that point in time. And in the middle of a pandemic, you can't think about yourself. You have to be selfless when you have children on the line. And being a product of the system, they look at us first. So place yourself in the middle of a pandemic and you lost your job. Now you don't know how you're going to pay rent. Now you don't have any Wi-Fi or internet to get on the school application, the school websites to do any homeschooling with your children. Now you're facing ACS. Now you're facing possibly losing your children. For me, that is my biggest fear. I feel like even aging out of foster care is a consistent battle because I have to maintain my living situation. I have to take care of my children. I have to stay out of ACS's limelight because it's so struggling. It's very, very struggling because they always look at us as, oh, she's a bad person because she was in care. Maybe she wanted to be placed there. But the reality of it is none of us asked to be in care. None of us asked to go through the things that we were going through. We're just trying to survive. We're just trying to be better products of society. We're trying to become nurses, doctors. We want to help our community. So I'm here today to speak on behalf of all foster youth that are on the street because we can't even sleep on the train anymore. There was a point in time where I could at least know that I can sleep one full night on the train back and forth and I would be okay. Now we can't even sleep on the train. We're banned from the trains. There's no safe place with this pandemic. There's no safe place for our youth right now. And I feel as if Governor Cuomo needs to open his eyes and see how very important this is for our youth to have a safe place to stay. Because imagine with three children, me on the street, what would I eat? Where would we go? There's no safe place. Every place is infected. Every place is under watch. We can't even go to the public parks. Like, this is the most scariest time of my life. And I can't even stress how scary it is for our younger youth that are on the street that don't have a mother and a father. My mom and my dad died before I could even get a chance to meet them. So all I've ever known was the state. My lawyers, judges, workers, and I'm so grateful to have the support that I have now. And this is why I'm so happy that we're all fighting so that our children can also have that support. Because God forbid if something was to ever happen to me, I want to know that New York State will be able to make sure that my children are taken care of. Because New York State was my mother and my father. So I want to speak today based on making sure that we have a safe place to go. We actually have a place for shelter. The shelters are not safe. The streets are not safe. The trains are not safe. No place is safe. So I just want to say thank you for like listening to a little bit of my story and everything that I've been through. And just know that I'm open to any questions and anything you guys want to ask.